Igor, I need a minute.
What's going on?
Something's up. NAR is being really active on the radio. They're looking for someone, supposedly a traitor and a thief. I managed to pinpoint the location. It's Kopachi, the village near the Pripyat River. This could be our ticket into the power plant. This person might know something important or have access to useful gear.
What do you think he could know?
Passwords, credentials, uniforms, even rations. And it should be a fairly straightforward mission. If you're smart and fast, you won't even have to mix it up with NAR.
You're right. This could be important. We should at least have a friendly chat with this so-called traitor.
I'm glad you see my point. It's in Kopachi. You can't miss it.
The enemy of my enemy is my friend, as they say. But can you ever trust a traitor, Igor? Trust is such a fragile thing, earned at a great price, yet so easily lost. But you never lost your trust in me, right, my love?
Look sharp. This asshole's gotta be around here somewhere. Eyes open. I don't need any more shit from Kozlov. I know. Damn Samichels. Nothing but thieves, drifters, and lunatics.
Why lunatics?
What sane person would choose to live in this irradiated wilderness? We asked them nicely to leave, yet they're still fucking resisting.
Hey, you're right. I wouldn't be here either, but they pay better than the army.
They must be looking for our mystery guy. Hey, you!
Jesus H. Christ, you startled me. Never, ever do that again while I'm working. In fact, never do that period, whether I'm working or not.
What are you doing here?
Well, someone sold me a combination for this safe, but...
But they pulled a fast one on you. That'll happen when greed gets the best of you.
What? No, greed is good. It makes the world go round. And this, well, chalk this up to an occupational hazard. Still, it's a shame. I paid good money for this combination. Maybe I can open it with some lockpicks.
They? Who's they?
Well, very important people in highly important places.
Oh, like who?
I can't tell you. If I did, I'd have to kill you. Just kidding.
I should hope so. So, any idea what's inside?
Something of great value, no doubt. Why else would they lock it? Jesus! I should have brought a crowbar or a stick of dynamite. Yeah, dynamite would definitely do the trick.
You got yourself in a tough spot here. What are you going to do?
Well, I can't open it, but maybe someone else could.
Maybe, but it looks pretty old. Might be that it's rusted shut on the inside or something.
Could be. Oh, fuck this junk. It's over. I'll give up.
You're giving up?
Well, it's not like I can call a locksmith here, can I? I've wasted enough time on this. You can try your luck if you want.
Completely stuck. Regular lockpicks won't do.
Don't hurt me! I'm unarmed!
Hands where I can see them. I take it you're the traitor everyone's so anxious to find.
What? Where did you get that? I know traitor. I was never even with the NAR.
You'll have to be a lot more convincing than that. Those spooks really want to find you. Your face is all over the radio.
All right. I used to trade with some of the grunts sometimes. But those knuckleheads got confused about how trading works. They tried to rip me off, and...
And what?
One thing led to another, and you understand. I took a few little items to balance the account. Obviously, they didn't want the brass to find out about their little side hustle, so they cooked up this yarn about a traitor.
Interesting.
Yeah, but not nearly as interesting as you, my friend. You're new to the zone, right? You've been staying in Mikhail's warehouse. I wonder what you're up to.
How did you know that?
I need to go now. They're probably worried about me.
Who's they?
Sorry, I can't tell you that. Please step aside. I'm going now.
No, you're not. We have no idea who this guy is, Igor. We turn him loose, he could run straight back to NAR and trade our lives for their forgiveness or some other kind of deal. Don't you even think about letting him go, at least not before combing through his stuff.
Sorry, but I don't like your story. Why don't you tell me who you really are? And let's take a little look-see in your bag while we're at it.
Who I am is none of your bloody business, and I'm not showing you shit.
We're both in a tough spot here. Maybe you're just a hustler, or maybe you're a spy. I can't just let you walk away.
Yeah, looks like we're in a bind, all right. Ball's in your court, asshole.
I really am sorry, but I can't take any chances.
Hey, Igor. How are you?
I'm all right. What about you? Have you started to regret joining our little suicide squad yet?
No way. I live for this kind of thing. And since Anton's death, it's personal for me now.
Hopefully you won't change your mind. Shadows, NAR, Chernobylite, it's all a bit overwhelming.
Years ago, I met a young pirate. Just a kid, really. I was part of a team retaking a hijacked cruise ship off the Somali coast. The kid's colleagues chained him to a machine gun so he couldn't escape, and told him to shoot anyone trying to board the ship. He was so scared when he saw us, he froze in place. The chain was too thick for us to cut, and we didn't know what to do with him. There was no way in hell we could turn our backs on a PKM. I could have knocked him unconscious, But a blow to the head with a rifle butt could just as easily kill him. So I did the only thing I could. I unloaded his weapon and broke the boy's fingers. On both hands, to be safe. When it was over, we brought him back to Canada. Trudeau found him a nice foster family. I understand you feel responsible for this mission, Igor. But I also have a stake in this. Trust me. I will do whatever it takes to see this through. Whatever it takes.
Do you think you could find some...
But I'll be...
Perfect. Let's do it.
Follow me. Now I'm going to teach you how to remain invisible when there's little cover. It all depends on how quick and quiet you can be. When concealed, look for the next closest cover to your goal. Observe the enemy, and once you see an opening, advance quickly while staying as low as you can. I'll play the role of your opponent. Begin. Good job, Igor. Your chances of survival just increased.
Thank you.
Hey, Igor. I'm glad you're learning these new moves so fast. It's important to keep improving.
Get up, Professor Khymynyuk. Time is of the essence.
You, what?
Meet me in Lenin Square.
What's our next move, boss?
Thank you. see you. I can see your thoughts. What's taking you so long? Find me. We belong together. Take my hand. I'll show you a new world. A world that you've never seen before.
All dead. Stuck in Chernobylite crystals. Crushed. Suffocated.
Thanks. I guess I never expected a stalker to come to my aid.
What was this all about?
Instead of helping these butchers round up civilians and shoot them, I ran. I couldn't leave the zone because of the perimeter, so I started a little trading operation to get by. Well, it didn't take long before my old NAR squad mates found me. Grisha, we used to be friends. We were close. But he couldn't forgive me for abandoning them. I think he was especially bitter about it because he was ashamed. I left, and he stayed. And did what he did. I killed our friendship, so Grisha volunteered to kill me.
never find her. Leave this place.
I'm worried about these nightmares you've been having. You should see Dr. Bruinoff again, Tanya.
What's he gonna do? Prescribe more pills that make me numb?
I'm sorry. I didn't want to. I love you.
I know. But I'd rather suffer the demon inside me than feel like a hollow shell.
I wish there was something I could do.
Just promise you'll never give up on me, my love. What do you hope to find among these trees, Igor?
You tell me, my love. You brought me here.
What are you talking about, Igor? Are you losing your mind?
Frankly, yes. I think I might be.
You came here because there's something you need to understand. Something to do with those dead trees. What they are, what they represent.
They're not dead. Not entirely. The radiation from the disaster killed all the microbes, which slowed decay almost to a halt. The Red Forest is like a snapshot in time, but there are signs that nature may recover.
Maybe it will, maybe it won't. Every inch of this area is still badly irradiated. Perhaps this horror will give birth to something entirely new. Perhaps it already has.
New?
Strange. Foreign. Alien. Something unfathomable. New. There's more I want you to see.
Thank you. This Kozlov guy seems to be important. Perhaps I should meet with him and ask about Tatiana. Watch your step, Tanya.
Don't worry, my love. I'll be fine.
Like when you fell out of that tree you were climbing. You almost gave me a heart attack.
I was trying to give you an apple, remember?
Try a low-hanging fruit next time.
Low-hanging fruits are not my thing, Igor.
Last known position. It's only a matter of time before I find him. You're beginning to try my patience, Professor. I detected the echo of a recent wormhole. It should lead me right to him. I have arrived at his last known position. It's only a matter of time before I find him. Make it harder than it needs to be. Found quantum traces of the portal generator. He must be.
Nuclear nano diamond battery level at 50%. Nuclear nano diamond battery level low. Warning. Nuclear nano diamond battery level critical.
The claw, the most irradiated piece of machinery in the zone. This might also be the most radioactive place in the zone, apart from the reactor core.
I know. It was used to remove the graphite from the roof of reactor number 3. 20,000 Röntgen per hour. Touching it with one's bare hands would practically be suicide. So the liquidators had to use machinery or robots whenever they could.
Both terrifying and fascinating, isn't it? Almost as if someone had accidentally opened a door to the inside of some dark, twisted star. Oozing power that should have been left untouched.
Where do you get these ideas from, Tanya? Probably all those science fiction books you used to read. Nuclear fission is just a method of producing energy. We became quite adept at harnessing it.
Really? This place doesn't inspire confidence in your assessment. I know what nuclear fission is, and you know that's not what I'm talking about.
I don't understand.
I think you do, my love. You said it yourself once. It's us, humankind. Are we truly ready to bear such a responsibility? We're like a bunch of chimpanzees trying to launch a rocket into space. What if the radioactivity is just the beginning? What if we stumble upon something even more powerful?
Chernobylite.
We need someone to guide us. Someone more significant than all of us. Someone or something.
Sometimes I wish humanity had one gigantic head.
What for?
So it could pull that head out of its gigantic ass.
Joke about it if it makes you feel safe, but it changes nothing. I'll show you. What do you know about them?
Well, When the Chernobyl reactor blew apart and the radionuclides started spreading, the authorities created an exclusion zone encompassing a 30-kilometer radius around the power plant. The people living in that area were evacuated, eventually. First, the Pripyat dwellers, then the other nearby hamlets. Kopachi, Yaniv, Poliska, Tarasi, Severivka, Vilcha, Kopachichi, Andriivka, and many more.
They were forced to leave, had to abandon their lives and their belongings. Their animals were shot, but some people refused to leave, didn't they? Or resettled later in secret. But why? Why would they do something so irrational, Igor?
They were sentimental, I guess. They must not have been thinking clearly.
You're the only one thinking clearly, aren't you, Igor? Always trying to reason your way out of every predicament. But people are different. They act on emotions, hopes, and fears.
Illusions.
Look who's talking. A mad scientist conversing with an imaginary woman. You think you know these people, but you don't. What do you know about this place? It's history. Do you have any idea what the folks living here went through? The Russian Civil War, forced collectivization, the Great Patriotic War, Nazi occupation, persecution by the NKVD.
History wasn't kind to this place, I know.
They suffered and lost so much, but they buried their dead and kept on going in spite of everything. This has been their place on Earth for generations. Do you think a bit of radioactivity would scare them away? People don't change that quickly, Igor. Maybe they don't want to, or maybe they just can't. Not many of them are left today. This place is dying. When the last of the sound shells passes away, it will be the end. What about you, my love? Will you embrace change if our fate depends on it?
Have a minute.
For you, partner, of course.
I can't stop thinking about what happened to Anton.
I know. I'm really sorry, Olivier.
He was one of the good guys, you know. And my friend. I can't help but wonder...
if we could have done something differently to save him?
You know what I'm talking about, right?
Only too well, Olivier. Only too well. Do you think you could find some time to teach me?
But I'll be...
Perfect. Let's do it.
Follow me. Taking out your enemy requires guts. Taking out your enemy quietly is an art. I think you've got what it takes to do the former, but you suck mightily at the latter. Now, the lesson is about knocking out your opponent without being spotted by him or anyone else. The secret lies in understanding human anatomy. It's about knowing. Let's put theory into practice. Sneak up on me and perform a chokehold. Don't worry about hurting me. I'm a professional. Let's begin. Okay, Igor, enough. That was impressive. Well done, soldier. did great, Igor. But remember, there's no such thing as too much practice. What's going on, Igor?
Do you think you could find some...
But I'll be...
Maybe some other time.
You're the boss, Igor.
Can we swap?
Sure, whatever you need.
Igor! Igor! I need you. I need you now.
Tanya?
Meet me in the Pripyat residential area.